In this video, we'll explore what is meant by the principal-agent problem and understand its implications for firms. A principal is an entity that appoints another entity, an agent, to make decisions on their behalf. For example, in this picture on the right, when you visit the dentist, you are appointing the dentist to take care of your teeth. If they make a suggestion, you're likely to follow it if you trust the dentist. The principal-agent problem arises when the agent has differing incentives to the principal. If you visit the dentist, you may want them to take care of your teeth at the lowest price possible, but the dentist has an incentive to earn revenue and make more than the minimum from you. This does not mean that every dentist is out to take your money, but it does mean there is a possible misalignment of incentives. This is one reason why individuals will often seek out online reviews or the opinions of friends and family before working with a dentist. In economics, we connect this idea with the divorce of ownership and control. This occurs when the owners of the firm are not the same people who are managing the day-to-day operations. This will be the case in some companies where shareholders own the majority of a firm but employ a board of directors to manage it. In a sole trader, the owner and manager are the same. In larger companies, that ceases to be the case when managers are appointed to run the company and have no ownership stake. Let's look at the principal-agent problem within a firm. If the owners of the firm appoint a board of directors or a management team to act on their behalf, the owners are the principal and the management are the agents. In this case, we have external shareholders who have handed over control to a management team. The problem arises when the owners of the firm want to maximize profit, but management wants to maximize sales to improve the company's market position. There could be various reasons for this, such as the individuals in management seeking career progression beyond the firm, and having grown a firm in size could be a valuable selling point for them. This assumes that management are paid fixed salaries to operate the firm. One possible solution to this problem is to compensate managers with shares as part of their compensation package. The owners could also link their performance to the profitability of the firm. Is this guaranteed to work? No. However, this is a step in the right direction towards resolving the principal-agent problem. You should have a better understanding of the meaning of the principal-agent problem and its implications for firms. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com.